In this video, we will discuss structures, which is a very important data type in C programming. Now, basically, we have done arrays, and we saw how arrays can be used to represent a group of data items, but those data items must have the same data type. This was a compulsion, though we had the advantage that we could collectively store all the datas, more than one data in a single data type, in a single data structure, that was an array. But the condition was that to be able to store them in a single array, they should have the same data type. Like all the integer numbers can be stored in a single array, all the float numbers can be stored in a single array, all the characters can be stored in a single array. But if I want to store integers and floating point numbers together, I cannot store them in a single array. Similarly, if I want to store characters and float data in collectively in the same array, it is not possible. So for that, C supports a data type or a constructed data type, which is structures, which is known as structures. So basically, structure, I can say, is a mechanism. The structure is a mechanism for packing or collecting different data types, that is the data items belonging to different data types, in a single data structure. So a structure, basically, I can say, is a convenient tool for handling a group of logically related data item. So when you want to handle a group of logically related data items. So what do I mean by logically related? That means in some or other logical way, they should be related to each other. Say, for example, if I take this example of a book. Now, there are so many things relating to a book or regarding a book which I want to store. Each book has an author name. That means the person who wrote that book. Each book has a title by which you recognize the book. Each book has a particular price. Each book has an year in which it was published, right? So these are different information regarding a single data item called book that you want to store. Now the data type of author would be char in this case. The title again would be char. The price would be float and the year would be an integer value. So that means different data types, but all this data, whether it is of author, title or price or year, is logically related to each other. Though they have different data types, but they are logically related to each other because they all belong to the same data item or same entity called book. So the condition is that in a structure, you can store all the data having different data types together, provided they are logically related to each other. They should be logically related to each other. Similarly, say for example, if you want to store information regarding a city. Now, city is one entity and there are so many attributes that of the city. Each city has a name. So the name would be character data type. Each city belongs to a particular country. So the country again would be a character data type. Each city has a certain population which would be floating or integer, which could be float or which could be integer. So the here again you can see that different attributes or different data items having different data types, but still they can be stored together in a single structure for city because they are logically related to each other. How? Because they all belong to the same city. Name of this particular city, country for this city and population for this city. So in a way they are logically related to each other. Hence we can collectively store all these data items together in a single structure. So this is the only condition. So the data of you cannot store the some of the data of book and some of the data of city in a single structure. Why? Because they would not be logically related to each other. But yes, you can store all the data related to a book in a single data in a single structure. Similarly, you can store all the data related to a city in a single structure. So the only condition is that they should be logically related to each other. And hence the problem of storing different data items having different data types in a single collectively in a single group, or grouping them together in a single data type is solved with the help of structures, because arrays is the data type which does not allow you to store different data items of different data types. But structure solves this problem by allowing you to store data items of different data types collectively in a single structure, provided they are logically related to each other, right? So basically, structures are helping you to organize complex data. So the complexity of data is being organized in a manner that you can store them in a single structure in a more meaningful way. So this now gives meaning to it, because book has so many things related to it. Book has an author, book has a title, book has a price, book has a year in which it was published, and collectively you store it in a single structure, so it becomes more meaningful and organized. Now let's come to a very important topic, that is defining a structure, right? So how would you define a structure? The first and foremost thing before using a structure is that you should define a structure, right? You must always define a structure before using it. Now see, till now you must have understood that basically the concept of a structure is similar to those of a record. Like you store records. In a college you have to store record. You store the records related to a student. You store the records related to the books. So basically structure is helping you to store the records together. Okay, so like the record of a book, books, the record of city, like this you can make structures for different data items. Now yes, that we were discussing that we should define a structure before we can use it, right? So the first and foremost condition is that structures must be defined before they can be used. Now how we can define a structure, we will see an example to illustrate this process. Now consider a book database, as I told you here also, I gave you an example. So we will consider the same book database. Now the database of a book would contain information related to book. Now what all information or what all attributes will a book have? A book will have a book name by which you recognize it. For example, if you have a book of C programming, so the book name is Yashwant Kanetkar. Then there must be a particular author who wrote the book. Like for C programming, you have the author. Sorry, the book name is Letter C. The author is Yashwant Kanetkar. Number of pages, say for you have 250 pages in that book, and price is 200. So there are so many information. There are so many information that is related to a book, right? When you store the record for a book, you need to store so many things related to the book. You need to store what is the name of the book. You need to store who is the author of that particular book. You need to store what are the number of these number of pages that this book has, and you need to store what is the price of that book. So all this information is stored collectively in a single structure for this particular book. Now, how do you define a structure, or how a structure is defined? Because before I use a structure, I should define it. So let us now see how I will define my structure. Okay, now consider this book database. As I told you, this has so many data items related to a book. The book name, yes. the author, yes, the number of pages, and then the price. So how will I define a structure for this book database? Structure can be defined as follows. First of all, you need to give the keyword struct. So this is the keyword which helps you to tell the compiler that you are defining a structure. So the keyword struct needs to be given first of all, that declares that you are defining a structure to hold the details of a particular database. So the first and foremost thing is the keyword struct. Okay, then you need to give the name of the structure. This book bank is called the name of the structure. So the second important thing that you need to give at the time of defining a structure is the name of the structure. Here I have given a relevant name, book bank, because I am storing information related to a book. This is also known as a structure tag. So this is also known as a structure tag. Okay. Then this declares that this particular structure named as book bank will be having four elements or members. So this is the first element. This is the second element. This is the third element. And this is the fourth element. So title of the book, author of the book, pages of the book, and price of the book. These are the four elements or four members of the structure which is named as book bank. So I call them the structure elements. Or the structure members. Okay, so each member can belong to a different data type. As I told you, I can store information of data items of different data types. Only they should be logically be related to each other. So all these members can be hence of different data types, right? Now this tag name or the structure tag, that is the book bank, is then subsequently used to declare variables. Alright, so this char title or char author or int pages or float price, these are not the variables of the structure, mind it. Don't get confused, these are not the variables of the structures, these are only the members of the structures. The title, the author, the pages, and the price, you call them the structure elements or the structure members. They are not the structure variables. The variables you will declare with the help of the structure tag or the structure name. So this thing needs to be kept in mind. So basically the above definition, this entire definition that you have seen, is known as defining a structure. So this is what you're doing here. You are simply defining a structure here. So this is how you define a structure. So basically you have seen that for defining a structure, there are three important factors. The first is the keyword, or the three important elements are the keyword struct, with the help of which you tell that you are defining a structure. Then the second element is the tag name, that is the name you give to the structure. Here the tag name is book bank, or the structure tag that you call it. So here the structure tag is book bank, and the third important thing here is the structure members. So here the structure is having four members, right? A title, which is an array of 20 characters, an author, which is an array of 15 characters, pages, which is an integer, and price which is floating point. So basically, what are the members here? If I talk of the structure members, the first member is title. The first member is title, which is an array of 20 characters. Then the second member is author, which is again an array of 15 characters. Then the third member is pages, which is an integer. And the fourth member is price, which is float. So these are not the variables, these are only the members. So you should not confuse them with the variables. These are the members. Variables you will declare later with the help of the structure tag or the structure name. So this thing, this definition of the structure or the structure definition simply describes a format which is called template, right? So this is basically describing the format of the structure or a template for the structure, that okay, this is how the structure will look, that any structure related to the, so any information related to the book bank, any data item related to the book bank or any variable of the data type struct book bank will have these four members. Any variable of the data type struct book bank will have four members or four elements, that is a title, which would be a array of characters maximum 20, author, which is again a character array of 15 of size 15 or 15 characters, pages, which is of integer type, and price, which is of float data type. So any variable of the data type struct book bank will have these four members. So this format or this template gives us tells us that okay, whatever variable of the data type struct book bank you declare will have this format or this template. So this is the sole purpose of having a structure definition or defining a structure, and it is compulsory to define a structure before you can actually use it. Now always remember that the structure's template is, or the structure definition is terminated with this semicolon, as you can see here. So every time you define a structure, the template will be terminated with a semicolon like this. Okay, now each member, this is one independent member, this is another independent member. So there are four independent members, and each member is declared independently for its name and data type in separate statement in the template, right? So though title and author both had data type characters, yet you declared them separately, right? So every member of the structure is declared independently for its name and data type in a separate statement inside the template. This is another important point. The third point, that the tag name or the structure tag or the name of the structure, like here you have the structure tag book bank, can be used to declare structure variables of its type later in this program. So this is just a template which defines that whatever variables of this type that you will declare in future will have these members, these four members. So this structure tag can be used to declare the variables in the future. Now, how do you declare the structure variables? Let's move on to that. We have defined the structure. Now the next task is to declare the variables of that structure. So how will you do that? Okay, so when you declare structure variables, when you do that, that is only after declaring the structure format or structure template, which is known as the structure definition. That is after defining the structure, you will declare the structure variables. So it is similar to the declaration of any other variable. Just like you declare any other variable, you declare the structure variables also, right? So what all things would it include? When you declare a structure variable, the first and foremost, the important thing that it would include is the keyword struct to indicate that it is a structure variable. Okay, then the structure's tag name to indicate that it belongs to this particular tag or structure name. Then the third important thing is that you then give the list of variable names separated by commas. You may have one variable, two variable, three variable. So all those can be declared then separated by commas. Just like in the case of any normal variable. Say for example, if you have an integer variable A, B, C. So this is how you declare them. Integer is the data type. Then all these variables are declared separated by a comma. Similarly, all the variables which are belonging to that particular structure will be declared like this, separated by commas, and at the end, just like this, you will give a terminating semicolon, right? So say for example, if I take the example of my structure book bank, right? So the I will always, to declare a variable of the structure book bank, what will I do? First of all, I will write the keyword struct. So my first condition is met here. I write the keyword struct. Then I give the structure tag name. What is my structure tag name? Book bank. Then I will write them here. So the first thing is the structure keyword. So I give the keyword struct. Then the second thing is the structure tag name. So the tag name is book bank. Then third is the list of variables. Whatever variables you want to declare, you can give a list of them, which would be separated by commas. So for example, I want to declare three variables, book one, then comma book two, then comma book three, and then all these variables, and the last thing is the terminating semicolon. So this I give here. So just like any other variable, you declare the structure variables. So this struct tells that the first condition is met. Keyword struct, I have mentioned, this tells that this particular variable is of the structure data type. Okay, the second is the tag name. This tells that this particular variable belongs to the book bank structure. Okay, then these are the names of the variables. These are the variable names. You can give as many as you want depending upon the requirement, and you will separate them by commas like this, and at the end when you are done, you will finish it with a semicolon. So this is very simple, just like any other variable. Only difference is that here you have to mention the keyword struct and the name or the structure tag. So this is how you declare structure variables. Okay, so we will see one more example. So now you have seen how we declare the structure variables. So the complete declaration would be like this. This is the complete declaration. So as I told you, you have the structure keyword, you have the tag name, you have the name of the variable separated by comma, and you have a semicolon. So all these four conditions are met. So this basically declares that book 1, book 2, and book 3 are variables. These are all variables of what data type? Of the data type struct book bank. Now the format or template of book bank has already been defined. So all these variables which belong to the structure book bank will have all those four members, right? So they will all have the title, author, pages and price, because that is already specified by the template of book bank. So any variable which is of the data type struct book bank will have by default all those four members. Now the complete declaration would be like this, that we will see. The complete declaration is like that. First of all, you give the structure definition, struct book bank. Then you define the members here. Char title 20, char author 15, int pages, float price. Then you complete the structure definition and with the semicolon. Okay, then immediately after that you define the variables. Like here you can see struct, keyword, book bank, the structure tag, and then the variables book 1, book 2, book 3, ended by a semicolon. So this is how you complete, the complete declaration is done. That means the definition is also, the structure definition and the variable declaration is done together one by one. This declaration can also be done in this manner. So this is also a valid declaration. That is, first of all, you give the structure definition, wherein you give the template of the structure, struct book bank, having these four members, title, author, pages, price, and then immediately after the semicolon, you write the names of the variables, that is book 1, book 2, book 3, and then end it with a semicolon. So both these declarations are correct. You can declare the variables in whichever way you want. So the first thing that you would do would define the structure, and the second thing that you would do is declare the variables. So this is all about structures. In the next video, we will discuss how you access the structure members.